pictures in frames of kisses on cheeks, and say you want me.
Together, oh, when I figured it out, yeah, yeah. Hi everyone, good morning, welcome back. So welcome back to DataCom lecture. So we are in week 3, lecture 2 now. And this week, today, I know it's very early, so thank you for joining me. And this is your official first day training as the wireman or the cableman. Okay, so today we'll be building our first local area network together, and we will be doing three things. So first, I will explain the concept of local area network, which is something that you have to learn about the theory. And then once you understand what are the devices that we use to build computer networks, I will show you a router, a hub and switch in real. So they are the real thing. I think we have seen that in a previous class. So today I'll be showing you how I'm going to connect them together. And once we are done, we will be building our own LAN, your first LAN together on Packet Tracer. And today is also the day that we are going to use the Try Hack Me challenge. So we will be having our first challenge together in a short while. So I'm going to show you how we will do that. Now, let's start with the theory part first. Okay, so I just want to give you a heads up, a little bit of warning before we start. This part is the theoretical part on what is a local area network. So if you are still on your bed right now, I think you should really move on to a table because it's not as interesting as you might think. But anyway, we still have to learn what do we mean by the LAN, and then how do we know how big is a LAN, how small is a LAN, and then how do we know the boundaries of a LAN. So let's talk about local area network. Now, the way internet is designed, like right now, whatever you are doing on the internet, like you can go on to Instagram, you can watch this live stream right now, is because of the client-server architecture. Meaning that every time when we try to use an apps, what happened exactly is that your apps on your phone or your mobile device or your laptop will try to connect to a server. which we put in a server farm or a data center somewhere in Singapore. We don't have any data center here for Instagram or Facebook. So normally they put it in Singapore, Taiwan, Hong Kong, China, and some other like tech-savvy country. So they have their own big data center. So of course in Malaysia, we have our own data center as well, which is in Cyberjaya. And of course, we also have some small data center all around Malaysia, but those are maybe for small SME companies and not the apps that we have been using day in, day out. All right, now for all the network that we have in data center or in your home network right now, we call them a local area network. So why we have this concept of a local area network? Now, the reason is because right now on the internet, there are so many devices. Okay, there are billions of devices. If you want to count, you can. Like just take the number of populations and then assuming that one guy have three devices, then you just multiply by three. That will give us like how many billions of devices. Now, we cannot just put all these devices together in a same network. All right. So if it is possible, then there is even like no need for us today this morning to be here. You can just go back to your bed right now. Thank you, class. And that will be a very short class today. But no, we cannot. The reason is because let's say I'm using the example that you see on the screen right now. I have 8 PCs here. They cannot all belong to the same lab. Okay, which means that somehow we need to say, okay, this is a local area network number one. This is a local area network number two. And within this LAN one, how big is it? How many devices we have in the network? So for example, let's say in your network, I mean like all LAN are different in sizes. I'm not sure about your house. Like if you are living with your family, then you might have a lot of devices in your LAN right now. Or if you're living alone, then you might not have as many. So the point here is that we cannot just put all the devices in one network. We have to put them into different physical local area network. Now, why is it so? Okay, the reason is because let's say I want to put all devices in a LAN. It is technically not possible. That's because what we have learned earlier. If you want to get online, the very first thing that we need is an IP address, right? Now, when we design LAN, every network will have their own network address. We will be learning more about network address in the next lecture. So for now, you just have to know that every network will have their own network address. And with this address, we can start to assign IP to different devices in a network. Now, it is not possible to put too many devices because we don't have enough private address, depending on how you design the network addressing. To give out to all the devices. That's the first reason. You cannot just put everyone in the same LAN because even if, let's say you do so, you might not have enough address for everyone. Now, it might not be very clear in your case, but let's say in Utah, if I just put all network, Sungai Long campus and Gampa campus into one big network, it is going to be a lot problem because then some devices might not have IP address and some will have. So some devices will not be able to get online. So if you do that, let's say today everyone, good news, okay, we found America, everyone come back to the campus, vaccine, everyone is vaccinated. Then everyone want to get onto the Utah Wi-Fi. Now, if we do one big LAN, some of you might not have an IP. So some of you might say, hey, why my friend can online, why I cannot online? Okay, so that is one problem. Now, the other thing is, if we put everyone in a big network, then sometimes it is more vulnerable in terms of security. It means that security is not as good. So you can think of this as an example. Let's say if I have all of these 8 PCs that you see here, I put them within a one big local area network. So let's say this is one big local area network, okay? And one of these guys happens to be a bad guy, say an intruder or an angry ex-girlfriend who hates you suddenly. Then if they are in one big LAN, I can launch attack like maybe a DOS attack or maybe a broadcast attack. Okay, don't worry about the type of attacks. This is just an example here to tell you that if you put everyone in the same net, this kind of attack will affect everyone. So all of these PC will be attacked. Okay, now, which is true. Let's say if your network is currently infected by some Trojan or virus or malware, then if it happens at the network level, everything in your network will be affected. Okay, so similarly, based on this thing, let's say if I want it to be safer. So instead of putting everyone in one network, I can maybe split them. So let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, the 4 PC on the left, we put in one LAN. Then the other side here, I put them onto the other network. Now in this case, let's say I have an angry ex-girlfriend who launched an attack and who happens to be a datacom student also, so she knows how to do it. You are also a student, but you didn't pay attention, so you do not know how to stop it. Okay, so let's say this happened. The attack will only go and affect all the same PC, a few PC in the same network, but it will not affect the rest of the PC which is in another local area network. So this is one of the reasons why we don't want all the eggs in one basket. You would always like to split them into different LAN depending on the network design, so that you can somehow or somewhat limit the range of the attacks. Alright? And if in a similar note, you can think of this like, okay, let's say we have different departments. You can also think of this as a security reason. So let's say I am from FICT right now, and I have my colleague which is from FBF. Okay, now when we do networking, we always split FICT faculty, which we are in our own network. FBF will be in their own network. We never mix together. Why? Because let's say today, Yuta don't pay me enough. Okay, then I am very angry. I want to do some hacking. So if I'm in a same physical LAN, so let's say I'm PC6, so let's say this is me, okay? I can launch an attack and then I can try to steal some data, like I steal the FA paper for this trimester. Then I sell it on eBay. Okay, this is just an example. Please don't post this on anything. Okay, that can happen. Now, of course, it doesn't mean that if you are in another network, I cannot attack you. But the logic here is that if we are in the same network, it is way more easier, very, very easy for me to attack you because we are physically in the same network. So let's say even for security reason, we would also like to place different departments into different network. Like even if you work in a big company, they will have HR department in their own LAN, and then you have technical programmer department in their own LAN. Alright, so this is a concept of LAN. And if you know the reason or the motivation behind why we want to build LANs, okay, it's not because I want to build LANs so that I can teach this subject, otherwise I'll be out of job. It's not that. It's because of the technical reason that I just said earlier. And the next thing we want to see is like how we are going to make them into different LAN. And to do so, we will have to look at three kind of networking devices, which is very, very common. Like, doesn't matter where you take datacom, in Taylor, in Sunway, or in Utah, you are going to learn these devices, all right? And this is because these three devices is really the backbone device that actually form networks. So you have a hub, a switch, and a router. Okay, so these are three different kinds of networking devices. Of course, there will be different versions or model and brands for all these devices, but in general, okay, we are talking in general, these are the three device type. And in general, they do almost the same thing. We use them to connect all the end devices together. So end devices is like your PC that you are using right now, okay? Or your phone or your iPad. So those are end devices. And yeah, the main reason we have them is to connect all these devices together so that we can be in the LAN. And then we can also go to another LAN, which is actually meaning that I go to the internet, all right? So yeah, but why we have three different devices? Why not I just say one device to rules them all, then I don't even have to study datacom. Just buy one device that works for everything. Now the problem is, if we have that kind of device, it is going to be very, very expensive, right? You don't see Apple selling iPhone 12 Pro Max only. Then how about people like us who want to have the Apple logo but cannot pay $5,000 for a phone? So you need to have different things for different needs. Okay, so talking about price. Comparatively, if you want to buy one of these things, hub is the cheapest one, switch is like in the middle, and router is the most expensive one. So I'm talking about comparing among the same tech spec, okay? Of course, if you go and get the most expensive switch, and you compare to the cheapest router, then of course the switch might be even more expensive. So at the same level, hub is the cheapest, and then you have routers, and then you have switch and then routers. Now technically, we can actually classify this device into levels. So when I talk about levels, I'm actually talking about TCP/IP levels. Okay, we will learn more about TCP/IP in lecture 8. So as of now, you don't have to worry about what do I mean by this. But you can just remember, okay, a hub is a layer 1 device, a switch is a layer 2, and then a router is layer 3. Now, of course, the higher the better, because it means you are actually smarter, okay? Now, so as the price. Now, why we have a hub and switch first? We want to first compare these two things. Okay, they are both, again, used to connect end device so that we have LAN, but the way we connect them and the way the network works when we build a network with a hub or a switch will be very, very different. So let's take a look at hub. Okay, I want you to focus only on these four PC here. So just take a look at PC 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, now let's say I want to connect them together right now to form a LAN or a local area network. Now, again, before that, I just want to give you a reminder. Sometimes people use LAN, which makes you sounds way cooler, like you are the tech guy. Or some people say this is a network. So they are the same. They are used interchangeably. Some people call them a subnet. So in this subject, when you see the word LAN or network or subnet, they are referring to the same thing, depending on whether you like cookies or biscuits. Okay. Now, Then coming back to this one here, if I build a network right now, the first device I try is a hub. So again, reminder, if I draw a H in the box, this means this is a hub. If I draw S in the box, this is a switch. All right. If I draw a circle with a cross, this is a router. So a hub, a switch, a router. Okay. First, we start with hub. Now I am going to connect them together using LAN cable, which is the cable that we have seen. Now the cables are all the same, alright? All the cables are the Ethernet Cat 6 or Cat 7 LAN cable. Only the device here will be different. So I'm connecting them together. Okay, now in this case, when I do this, the whole region here, PC 1, 2, 3, 4, they will become one LAN. So all these four PC right now, they join the same local area network, okay? They are in the same single physical local area network right now. Okay, now, which means that that's it for now. Now, if I do this, it is going to be very cheap, and all these four PC right now will be able to talk to each other, which means that PC1 can talk to PC2, can talk to PC3, and also can talk to PC4. Anyone here can talk to anyone because we are in the same network right now, provided that you have an IP address, all right? So the next thing I want to try is I want to build the same kind of network, but instead of using a hub, now I will use a switch. So let's see how it works. If I put a switch here, and again, I will connect them all together with the physical cable. Now, when you do this, they will also give you one LAN. So now all of them will belong to one physical network. All right. Now, at this stage, you will be asking, I don't see any difference. Yes. On this diagram, you will not see any difference yet. In a while, I'll show you why they are different, why you want to pay more for a switch, why not just buy the cheapest hub. All right. But as of now, you should understand, if I connect this four PC together, they are now in one same physical network. It doesn't matter how many I connect. So I can do something like I connect PC X, PC Y. Okay, if I add more and more PC right now, they are all going to belong to the same network if they connect to the same switch. All right. Now this is the simplest way to put it. Of course, one day you will see some more difficult example like they are connected to the same switch, but they are actually in different network. Now that is different, that is virtual LAN. Okay, we don't want to go there yet. So as of today right now, if you see device connect to a switch, they are all in the same LAN. Okay, Now, so then why we want to pay so much for a router? Let's see why suddenly, why most people buy router, and even your house, you are using a router right now. Okay, so why we need router? Is it because so that it's more atas? Okay, you see, now I'm going to connect these four devices together again using a router. And same thing, I will connect them to together using four cables. Now, in this case, it is a bit different. So they are no longer in the same LAN. When you connect three or doesn't matter how many devices together to a router, they will give you multiple LAN, not one LAN anymore. So in this particular example, you'll get one network here. This is one LAN. And then you will have another network here. This is LAN number two. And then you will have a third network here, LAN three. And then you will have one more here, LAN four. Now, I want you to see the difference here. Hub and switch, they are the same. Doesn't matter how many you connect, they will all just join a big physical LAN. But for router, it's a bit different. Every time you connect one cable to that router, that one connection or one link will give you one network on its own. So they are going to be different network. So in this example here, I have this router, and on this router, I have four ports. So let's take a look at the one on the top. When I connect this one here using a cable to a PC, PC1 will be in its own LAN. The same thing for PC2, PC3, and PC4. So this is how we look at it. The simplest way to look at it is every time you connect one cable to a router, you are actually building one new physical network. So the same idea here. Let's say now I add one more device, PC5. This PC5 will again be in its own network called LAN. So this is the idea here. And before we go further, I need everyone to be very, very clear about each other. Like, this is what happens if you connect multiple devices using a router. Okay, so why not R in a square? This is such a good question. I have to ask Cisco. Okay, now if they are in the same, if they are in different LAN, can they talk to each other? So thank you. Chinese guy, for this very good question. So your friend is asking on the chat. Now, logically, are they any different? So you can see there are already difference here. But do you think they can talk to each other if I connect them like this? Actually, yes, they still can. They still can if you have IP address. The only difference here compared to the one that we see earlier where everyone is in one big LAN is that they will have different network address. So in the first example, all the devices will belong to one big LAN, so they will have the same network address. So in this case, all people will have different network address. Okay, now again, like I say, our network address will be in the next lecture, so you don't have to worry about it first. Okay, now you see, I think by now everyone can start to see like, okay, why router is somewhat a bit more expensive. Okay, the reason is because right now, if you really think about this, we are actually building different network, which is what I say during the start of this stream. We want to put different people or different device into different network depending on the needs, like whether you're from different departments, you're from different house, you're from different campus. So even like if you are one day you come back here, okay, you are staying in Westlake. So you know Westlake, we have so many students who stay in Westlake, right? But even if you are just physically next door, and then both of you subscribe to Unify, you are actually belonging to different network, two different network. Okay, even in the same house, if you subscribe to two Unify account, and then you get two router from TM, you are also in two different network, even though you are just like 1 meter away. Okay, now this is because you connect using a router. So that is the trick here. If you want to build more networks, you buy a router. If you just want, you just need one network and then you don't care about breaking them into smaller networks, you just want everyone to talk, like if you want to host a LAN party and then you don't have an internet connection, so you just need to use a hub or a switch. Alright, so that is the idea here. Now, then if you're okay, we are going to talk a little bit more about why a hub and why a switch. Why not just buy a hub? Okay, so same example. Okay, now I will rebuild the network here, but this time I will show you how a hub is different than a switch. So earlier we have already done this, and we know they will now be in the same LAN. Okay, so I will just color code this right now so that you know they are in the same LAN. And that is what we call the LAN boundaries. Okay, now in this case, if I connect all four devices using a hub, the way it works, it's like, okay, they still talk to each other, but it is not as good compared to a switch in terms of two things. So the first thing is the performance, it won't be as good. Okay, the network performance. So when we talk about network performance, I'm talking about whether there will be congestion, whether you can get enough bandwidth or throughput, whether it will affect the latency of the applications. All right. Now the second reason, I mean, the second downside would be you have some security issues. Okay, now the first one, why we say hub is not as good as a switch when it comes to network performance. So the reason is because hub is like really, really dumb. It's a layer one device, which is why it is cheap. It doesn't mean cheap things are always dumb, but yeah, hub is actually not as smart because it doesn't understand networking. Really, it doesn't understand networking, but somehow it is a network device. So what a hub can do really is just to forward packets to all people as it get the data. So let's take a look at this example. Let's say right now PC1 is trying to send a piece of data to PC2. Okay, so technically this is supposed to happen. So you have a data starting from here, and this piece of data should travel to the hub, and then it goes to PC2 here. This is PC2. Okay, now this is what we want. But a hub is not as smart. So when it is doing this thing, it also sends the same piece of data to everyone else that is currently connected to it. So what will happen is the same piece of data will also be copied, one extra copy to PC3. And then another extra copy to PC4. So you can think of this as hub is actually broadcasting, meaning that instead of just sending the data to the right destination, the hub somehow send it to everyone else who are actually connected to it right now. So we call this a broadcast type of message delivery. Okay, so I hope you get this picture here. Now I can give you another example. So let's say, okay, let me redraw this thing here. The same thing will happen if I have a hub here. And now if PC2 is trying to send something to PC3. Now what we really want is the data comes here and gets to PC3. But while this happens, the same piece of data will also be replicated to any other host which is currently connected to the same hub. And that is why we have security issue. Now think about this. If we are staying together in the same hostel and I have a girlfriend, you know what girlfriend and boyfriend do when they are lonely and then it's MCO, they are stuck in the room. I mean, stuck in two different rooms. If you are in the room, you don't need a phone. Okay, then you know what they send. Okay, so it's not everything you want to see. Now, if you do this using a hub, whatever your friends send, you can also see, which is a bit weird, like, why are you sending me this kind of photo? Okay, so this is not good if you use a hub to build a network. Now, if you don't care about security, then this is not an issue, okay? If you just want to save money or you're poor AF, then you have no choice, you still have to get a hub. Now, this security issue, later you'll see it will be fixed when we change the hub to a switch. Alright, now the second thing that we think hub is not as good is because of performance. Now think about this. every time I send a piece of data, so let's say this is one picture, okay, this is a JPEG file. By right, it is supposed to go from PC2 to PC3, only one copy, but this hub go and make two extra copy and send to two other people who is not supposed to even see that picture. So you are actually sending three JPEG now instead of one. Do you see that? So you are, when you are doing so, you're actually adding more loads to the network because you are creating unnecessary traffic that is not supposed to be there in the first place. All right. So think about this. This is just one JPEG, but in the real network, we are sending thousands of millions of bytes per second. So every time I do something, you are actually repeating the same actions for so many times, depending on if you have more devices that are connected right now, it is going to be even worse. So yeah, think about this. You are actually adding so many loads to the traffic, to the network. And somehow, if this is really scaled up, it is going to be bad for network performance because then your link bandwidth will be utilized to send all this kind of traffic that is not supposed to be sent in the first place. All right. So this is why hub is only for poor people. Now, if you go to a friend's house and then you see a boy, he is using a hub, please go and get another guy. That guy cannot financially, he cannot make you happy. So go and get a guy who is using a router or a switch. So now, coming back to this example, right now I will replace the same thing here with a switch. So same network, nothing changed except in the middle I changed the network device. Okay. So if my house only have me and me, a hub would be fine. Why this is so 18? Don't make my channel 18. I got many children watching this video. If you have a girlfriend still using a hub, if it is okay if you are staying alone, two people, then it's okay. If you have a third friend, then maybe it's not so okay. Now, let's talk about switch, okay? So you see, now I paid a little bit more money and I get a lot like peace of mind because now I know nobody can eavesdrop on me anymore. Okay, so think about this. Same thing, PC1 send a piece of data to PC2. Now in this case, the data will still go to the switch and then it goes to PC2 and yeah, that's it. That's it. This data will not be replicated further. Nothing is going to be sent to PC3 and PC4. Now we call this a unicast message, meaning that I only have one sender to one receiver. Okay, now this is what we want if you want to have a secure and fast network. Now, same thing. If we do this, only one to one. So PC3 and PC4 will not get to see what I'm sending. Okay, unless your girlfriend is also my girlfriend. I don't know how it works, but yeah, you want to have this kind of security in your network. Otherwise, later on, I don't know, from the previous class, this is what they told me. Every time I watch a YouTube video on something, the next day, my parents also get recommended with the same kind of video. So it's very, very dangerous. Think about it, depending on what kind of video you normally watch. So I don't know why it happens. It might not be networking, it might be the algorithms, but yeah, just take note, something that you should know. Now, same thing. For performance, it is going to be really great because now what I send is what you receive. So one-to-one, I'm not adding more data, I'm not building extra data, I'm not adding any payload. So it will not add any further load to the network, which might already be congested in the first place. All right. So yeah, always pay a little bit more to buy a switch. Yes, this is why your friend know that you like to drink Milo, and then every night before you sleep, he make a cup of Milo for you. If you see that kind of people, change hostel. Okay, so yeah, by now you are supposed to know why we have hub and switch. Hub is for poor people, switch is for richer people. Router is for you when you want to build more networks. Alright, so now if you know this, then we'll go back to your slides and we will go through something which is slightly more challenging to wake you up before I do the unboxing for you. So I need you to open the slides 2B. And then you move to land boundaries. Okay. Based on what we have just learned, now we want to really try to see the next skill that I want you to pick up is, let's say today you work in a company like Huawei or Cisco, and then your boss said, show me how many network that I have in Huawei campus. We need you to be able to tell immediately like how many, 5 or 6 or 7 or just one big network. So this is how, I'm going to show you how you tell in a short while, okay? Okay, why the switch tech is still not developed cheaper? Why it's not cheaper? It's very cheap. Actually, it's already very cheap. The switch is not expensive. It's like 3 to 4K for an 8-port switch, campus grade. Of course, not the one you use at home. 3 to 4K. Router is about 8K for 2-ports router. Okay, our money. So I don't think it's expensive. It's not. It's actually our problem. We are poor. It's not that they are expensive. Economy are great. Every time people say economy are bad, but iPhone always out of stock. The new MacBook already out of stock. So it's actually it's our problem. Okay. The switch is less likely to suffer from packet loss. Yeah, that is correct. Thank you for the very great questions. So your friend is asking between hub and the switch. Can we say that switch is going to be better because less packet loss? Yes, that's true. Because in the hub network, when I'm sending and you are sending, everyone is sending together. Sometimes you are, depending on the connections, if you're using a half duplex connections, then you have the chance to have packet collisions. And when that happens, then you have packet loss. Or if you are giving too many work to the hub, the network device, because let's say too many traffic, so I have to send out so many traffic at once at 1 second, then sometimes packet loss. Okay, so this is why technically this is a very good way to say it. Switch is less likely to suffer from packet loss. Alright. So if you look at this diagram here, now this time this is getting more complex. But don't worry, okay, don't panic. First tips in datacom is don't panic, because they always try to make you panic first. So don't panic if you get questions like that and they ask, how many network do I have here? Or how many LAN do I have here? So the theory is always the same. The idea is you always look at the type of networking device. Now, again, a hub and a switch, doesn't matter how many devices we connect to them, it always gives you one physical network. For a router, every port, or we call that interface, every interface or every link that you connect to a router will give you one new physical LAN. Alright, so if you look at this diagram here, I have I will just highlight in red color all the networking devices. Okay, I have 4 routers, and then I have a few PCs and a few servers, one server and a printer. Now, how many network do I have here? If you look at the hub first, okay, let's start with the hub. We know that it doesn't matter how many devices you connect to a hub, they all belong to the same LAN. So in fact, all the connections here, okay, doesn't matter how many, they will be in the same network. Alright, so next, I have another network device here, switch. Same concept, doesn't matter how many I connect, later on, they will be in the same LAN. So in fact, technically, because of this design here, which is a bit weird, designed by a cycle, they are all in the same network. So I will now color this one in yellow color, the region of the LAN boundaries, okay? So because of the concept we said earlier, this one now, they are all in the same LAN. Until router. So router is the cutoff point. Router is where you draw the border, the boundaries, because every time, like I say, one port give you a new network. So here, I have one port, two port here. Okay, so this give you a boundary. You will cut off here. Okay, now this is a bit complex. Might be unfair to you because this is the first time you're seeing this, but it's already so hard. Yeah, it doesn't matter also because now you see all these routers are connected to the switch and hub. And what do we say? Every time you connect to the same switch and hub, you get the same one network. Alright, so if this is too difficult, you can look at here. This is the idea here. Every time you have a router, it will give you one, every link will give you one new net. Okay, so this one, the idea that you are seeing here is you have a few routers connected to the same switch or hub, then they also belong to the same network. Alright, so here the answer is one. Okay, there is only one big network here. Now, unless I do something like this, I add another PC here. Okay, then now this is two network. This is network number two. Okay, now I hope you can see this clearly. And I'm blocking the view. Hold on a minute. Okay, now, yeah, this one. So, the concept is the same. Hub and switch always give you one big network. Routers, depending on how many port that is active, it will give you more and more networks. Alright? Okay, next. Let's try this example. So, yeah, now we have even more devices, we have even more connections. This is cycle number two. This is next level cycle. But cycle is always sweep. That's why we have sweep but cycle. Okay? Don't judge people from the outside. Okay, now, how many networks do we have here? Let's look at the kind of networking device we have first. Okay, I will color them for you in orange color. So I have one switch here, two switch, one hub. This is a more expensive switch, a switch, and a hub. Now the rest in green color are end device. So a few servers and a few PC here. Alright, now how many networks do we have? Again, just look at the kind of networking devices. Now in fact, in this case, if you want to do this step by step, of course you have to see each of them and then you will see like, okay, now if I connect hub, everything to hub, then it belongs to the same net. So that is the right way, but that is a shortcut. If you look at here, there is not even a router or not even anything that looks like a router. So what we can tell immediately is they are all belong to the same one big LAN. Okay, because no router. Yeah, that's true. Cheese and pizza is good. I think if you eat more cheese and pizza, you become smarter in some way. So in this example, it's one big network because there is no router. Okay. So, router is not connected to any end device. Okay, yeah, Chen. So, Yap is asking, is saying something correct. So, on the chat, you can see Yap is saying router is not connected to any end device. Normally, it will not. Because, like I say, router is expensive. If you buy a router and you connect one PC to it, unless you're very, very rich, you can do that. Normally, we don't do that. So, the right way to do is we always connect all device, end device to a switch. And that switch will go to the router. Okay? Yeah, so if you're okay with this, then we go to the last example before we take a short break. And after the break, we start to do unboxing. Okay? The part every month, the moment everyone is waiting for is coming to you. So, last example of this part one. Okay, now here, how many networks do we have? Answer is already given. So if you want to cheat a little bit, yeah, you can. The answer is already here, but let's try to do this on our own. Okay, now the easier way or the faster way is just look at the router. So router, I have two router here, router 0 and router 1. We start with router 0 first. So let's look at router 0. How many connections do I have right now? I have one here. So this will give me one network. This will give me second network. this will give me the third network. Okay, three line means three network. So here I have, okay, let me change this wording. 1, 2. So you see here I have network number 1 here. I have network number 2 and I have network number 3 because there are 3 connections for this router. Okay, so far I already have 3. Then let's go to next router. So in this router number 1, same design, I have 3 ports. So 1, 2, 3. In fact, it will give me 1, 2, 3 LAN. Okay, so the one here is called LAN 4. So I have another LAN here called LAN 4. And then I have another one called LAN 5, which is here. And I have one more for this one here, sorry. Now this one here is already, of course we know it will be the third LAN, but here is already, we already colored. So we don't want to count again, we don't want to repeat this, which means that we don't want to count for the blue color network again, okay? Now, the idea is that when you have two routers that are connected together, like this in the blue color zone, they still belongs to one network. Alright, although we say that one cable or one link in the router give you a new network, but when they are connected together, they are considered as one network for LAN 3. So in fact, in this case, the total number of LAN that we have are 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because the one in the middle, we count them as one only. Although right now, I have 6 links on 2 different routers, I only have 5 LAN. Okay, so I hope you are clear with this. And if you are not, I'll give you 10 minutes to catch up to where we are until 9. So my time now is 8:50. Just give me 10 minutes to set up the unboxing area. And then when we come back, I'll show you the real hub switch and router in person so that you can hate the hub even more. Okay, so go for a coffee break and then I'll come back in 10 minutes. Okay.
You know the tears are rolling down your face, and it feels like yours was the only heart to break. When you come back home and all the lights are out, and you're getting used to no one else being around.
I'm like a tattoo that's over your heart. Cause once I put this love on you, it never comes off. I'm like a tattoo that's under your skin. So write my name in cursive, cause you'll never forget. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, no, 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 no. You want my kisses to start at your neck.
Show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over, sideways, and under, on a magic carpet ride, a whole new world, a new fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming.
A whole new world, a dazzling place I never knew. But when I'm way up here, it's crystal clear that now I'm in a whole new
to see.
I'm like a shooting star. I've come so far. I can't go back to where I used to be. Every turn a surprise. Every moment red letter. I'll chase them anywhere. There's time to spare. Let me share this whole new world with you.
A whole new
Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase.
Hakuna Matata. It ain't no passing craze.
It means no worries for the
It's our motto.
What's a motto?
Nothing. What's a motto with you?
Nice.
Boom.
Those two words will solve all your problems.
Yeah. Take Pumbaa here. Why? When he was a young warthog.
When I was a young warthog.
How you feeling?
It's an emotional story.
He found his aroma lacked a certain appeal. He could clear the savannah after every meal.
I'm a sensitive soul, although I seem thick-skinned.
And it hurt that my friends never stood downwind.
I was always here for you and I resent
that. Oh, the shame!
Yes, he was a shame.
I thought of changing my name.
I mean, to what, Brad?
And I got downhearted. Every time that I farted, are you gonna stop me?
No, I'm not. You disgust me. Hakuna Matata, what a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata, ain't no passing craze.
It means no worries for the rest of your days.
Yeah, sing it, kid.
It's a problem-free philosophy.
Hey guys, welcome back to the Unbox Therapy channel. So today I'll be unboxing three network devices. You cannot see my face anymore because I only have one camera. So now my hand will replace my face. I hope you understand hand gesture. Okay, so we'll start with hub, and then I'll show you next is switch, and then I'll show you the most expensive one is router. Okay, but this one, hub, is also exclusive because I don't think you can find a hub easily anymore this day, because this day everybody is rich. So this is a 3COM hub, and let's see what we have inside. Here. You cannot find this anywhere else on YouTube. Okay. I'm sorry to the box. So yeah, this is a hub. Let's look at it. Okay, a 3COM hub. Let me find a good angle for you. Okay, this is a 3COM hub. So it's very small, like I can just hold it in one hand, because it's really dumb. Like I say, it's a layer one device, and on the back it's really nothing much except you have 8 ports. So this is where you put in the LAN cable, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is a 8 port hubs. Okay, it means that you can invite 8 friends over, and then you guys can play online. LAN party together, but maximum is 8 people. So nothing much to see here. This is not hub, this is just the cooling ventilation. But the design is not bad. For this price, looks like Opera Sydney House. I like it. And then it's white color. I buy everything in white, so I still like this thing. But this one, like I say, is a broadcast device. So if you want to have a good performing network, you shouldn't buy this. And also, let's say you are worried about security, you shouldn't buy this as well. But if you're really poor, then just get this one, okay, if you want to get connected. So yeah, like I said earlier, it's a really cheap device. You can get this probably about 100 to 150 our money. And if even you put this outside on the floor, the next day you come back, you will still see this thing there. Nobody is going to steal your hub, okay. So yeah, this is a hub from 3COM. Of course, you will have hub from other manufacturer lah. And we have a power brick here. This is not a real unboxing channel, so I'm not going to show you all the cables here. And now I'll show you a switch. Okay, I'll show you a switch. How much for it? Maybe we do a giveaway. We have so many hub here in Utah. If one of these is missing, I don't think they will know. Then we just do a giveaway. I don't think anybody want this also. Now let's look at a switch. DHL is here. Our switch is here. This is from Cisco. Hold on. Yeah, this is better. If you get this, what can you do? Use it as paperweight. That's what I do also. Now, let's see what we have inside this one here. So this is a switch. It's not as big. I mean, it's bigger than the hub, of course, because it's actually smarter. So let me see what we have inside. Hold on. Let me move this up. I need a personal assistant to control my camera. It's a bit messy, definitely from eBay, second hand. It's not new. Okay, so you have the cable, like I said earlier, the first thing that you have is always you have this console cable. So this one I've shown you earlier, later we'll see how we connect them. And then you have another console cable. Maybe Cisco think I'm going to lose the first one, so they give me two console cable. Let's see what else we have inside. Yeah, and then the switch itself, the real switch itself. Okay, let's throw the box away in stuff. And this is a Cisco switch. So yeah, a Cisco system, which you know is a premium device. Everything that you put this logo on, it become automatically become more expensive. And this is in mint green color. Later you will see, like all Cisco devices, this is their signature color, mint green color. And it's really nice design actually, if you ask me. So clean, so minimalist. I like all the minimalist look. Too bad it's not in white color. And then yeah, look at the back of a switch. Something similar. Eight ports, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Which means that this is an 8-port switch. The maximum device and device you can connect to is 8. And the difference here, this is the difference here. Like you don't see this on a hub, but now you have this thing called a console. And this console is, if you remember, is the port that we are going to connect this cable to. Now, again, this thing here doesn't have keyboard, mouse, monitor, no I/O, no input, output. So if you want to make any programming on it, like change the IP or change the MAC address table, things like that, you need to find a way to get it, which means you need to connect this guy here to a PC. And the way you connect this is by using this cable, this one here, and you just put this into the console port. Okay, I won't talk for a few seconds so that you can enjoy the ASMR sound. Wow, not so loud. Let me try a new cable. We need ASMR in the morning. Ah, that's it. That is the sound I want. So yeah, this one here goes into the switch, and then this one goes to the end of the PC, which has the RS-232 port. Then you can just like control this thing like how you normally control a PC. Okay, this is a whole PC. Inside you have the processor, you have everything. You have the IC, you have the operating system that is built by Cisco. It is called Cisco iOS, not the Apple iOS. Somehow they share the same name. So yeah, everything is just like a PC, a mini PC, but it doesn't run Facebook or Instagram. It only runs networking protocols, all right? Yeah, this is really light also. I can just hold it in one hand, one-handed, no problem. Okay, now, later on, we come back to this switch, and then I'll show you even more. Because just by looking at this, it's not fun. You can see this from Google, it's not fun. So later, I show you something you cannot Google. We open this thing. 50 light, I'll open this thing and then we see inside what is inside. Okay, I'm just kidding. No light also, I will open it for you. Now, before I forget, this thing here, what is this yellow color one? Again, this is something that you don't have on a hub. Okay, now this is where you connect a switch to a router. And with this port, you can connect to the internet. Okay, now again, we do not directly connect any device to a router. It's just too expensive. So we connect everyone to a switch, and then we connect this one switch using this port to a router. Then you get internet connection. So this one is not if you compare them, this is a bit different. It's yellow color because this is faster one. This could be a gigabit port. This could be just a fast Ethernet port. This has to be faster because it needs to support so many people here. to go to the internet. Okay, so this is a Cisco switch. Alright, now if you saw this anywhere outside, you should always pick this up and sell it on eBay because this is worth about 3 to 4K. So this is not bad. But now I'll show you router first, even more expensive. And if you are going to steal anything from the lab, steal the router. Let me find the router. So this is the box of a router. What is a nice chain? Very tight, very nice. Oh my god, what kind of whisper do you want? Okay, now let's see what we have here. This is really expensive. I think I told you this before, 8K. So I have to be very careful, very gentle. I cannot throw the box. Look at me. I'm so discrimination. Because it's expensive, we have to take proper care of it. It's my 1 month salary here. Let's see what we have inside. Hold on a minute. Okay. Again, looks like second hand. So messy, but anyway, never mind. I just need the router. Wow, this is really heavy. This is also next level as ASMR. Are you ready? Yes, please don't give me any pressure. I have to be very careful with this guy. Okay, let me find a better angle for you. So yeah, this is a Cisco router. This Cisco router. So you can see here, 18 series. This is the cheapest router that you can buy from Cisco. And this, the first thing that you will notice is like, okay, again, something similar to a switch, looks like just a blue box. So you cannot really tell apart between a switch and a router just by looking at the front panel. You have to go to the back and then you see how it is different. So looking at the back of the router, wow. Wow, this looks like something you saw in a spy movie. So this is a router, okay? Now, of course, this is not the kind of router that you see. Okay, please don't go to your room right now and then find your router. Mom, where is our router? And then you see why it's so different. Because it's definitely different, okay? The router that you have right now is a router for your home network. This router is for core network, ISP network. So this is used by the internet provider. It's not by normal average people. But if let's say you go to a friend house, you saw this router, then definitely go and tackle that guy. If it is still, he is still single, then you know that is the right person, that is the one. Okay, now we will go through all these things here. I'll tell you what, how we connect each of these ports. So first thing you notice is it's very, very different, because now, like we said earlier, this is a router and we use this device to build network, right? So, which means that the logic is a lot more complex. Now, looking at the first thing here, I want you to focus on this part here. Okay, now, my first question is, how many network do you think I can build with this router? This router that I have here, how many? Look at the ports, how many? Come, tell me. I want to know how many people eat cheese and pizza. 2 and 4. 200. 200 is next level. 2 and 4. 3. Okay, not bad, not bad. We have half. So I think only 50% of you need to eat pizza and cheese. Okay, now the answer is 2. 2. Okay, why? Because if you see this thing clearly, well, I really cannot hold this in one hand. Now, the ports, they look the same, but not all is to connect LAN cable. Some is connect console cable. So you see FE01, FE00. Now this two port is to build network. This is where you put in the LAN cable. Wait a minute. So this is where you connect the LAN cable. Okay, so let's say you have a LAN cable here. Again, ASMR is coming like this. So this will give me one network. If I connect one more here, then it give me another network. Okay. Now I never try to connect it back together. Hey, have anyone do something like this? Can we connect this back together? Suddenly this strike me. I want to try this. Wow, what happened if we do this? Wow, this is such a cool sick setup. But don't try this. This is not supposed to be part of the lecture. Okay, now so you're supposed to connect another LAN cable here. Okay, then you have one network and two networks. Okay, now this port here cannot connect LAN cable one. You see, it looks like I can put in. But if you do this, no connection, it doesn't work one. Because this one is for console. So this one you want to connect the console cable. And the reason is the same. Like what I said earlier for the switch. Router, no monitor, no keyboard, no mouse. So you need this thing connect here. And then this thing connect this side, connect to a PC. Then you can do some programming like set routing, set IP address for this router. So this is the management port. It doesn't create any network for you. Okay, now the same thing for aux. This aux is also management port. So let's say this port is broken, you cannot set anything on the router. You can still use this as a backup. So these two are for management port. These two are to build more network. Okay, now let's say if you want more network. So my next question, what should I do? Now I know I can build two network. But what if I need three network? What should I do? Come on, somebody give me a good suggestion. What should I do? Connect to a switch. Use a splitter. Connect to a switch still is one network, ma, because switch doesn't give you more network. Yes, Ming Li, you are my favorite guy now. Connect to another router, but it's not really true. Connect to another router means that you are just connecting network. If you want to build more network, yes, smart people, these people solve problem with money. Buy a new router. That is correct, buy a new router. Now, of course, before you do that, you see here, we got one more slot. So you can actually buy one extra card, and then you put it in, then you can build more network here. Okay, just like if you're in your PC, you want to play game. One graphic card cannot support 4K, so you buy two graphic cards, then support 4K gaming. You can always add more ports here until, let's say, you really run out of all these ports, then only you buy a new router. Okay, so the other day, we also see this big blue cable. Now, just now mainly say connect to another router. That's exactly what I want to do now. So, router in itself is useless. It's just like a switch. If I build two networks, it doesn't give me anything except like I have two new networks. But the right reason we want this is because I want the network here and here to go to the internet. So, routers have to connect to routers. In the core network or the ISP or the backbone network as you call it, you have many these kind of routers and they're all interconnected together. And we use this cable, this one here, alright? So this thing will go right into this slot here. Just like that. No sound. This one no ASMR sound. So if you are trying to increase your volume for the ASMR, don't. There's no sound for this port. Yeah, like this. Okay. Now, of course, the other end looks similar. This one. And this will go into another router. Exactly like this. But for another router. And that is how we connect two routers together. But of course, I cannot show that now because I only have two hands here. So I cannot connect another router to show you. But yeah, I think you get the idea here. This is how we connect routers and router together. Alright? So yeah, this is Cisco 184 routers, which is the router that you will be using throughout this trimester. But disclaimer here, I have to tell you a truth. Because you follow me, I don't want to lie. You cannot use this router because it's online class, so you can only use the fake router on Packet Tracer. Anyway, yeah, that is the router. So now I will show you the inside of a switch if you want to. If you want to, let me know if you want or not. If you don't, we can just skip that part because like I'm not sure if you are into those kind of thing. Okay. You want to see router? Okay, I'm going to sell this to you, cheese and pizza. Once you pay for this router, then we unbox the inside for you. This one cannot open one. If I open, I'm sure I cannot put it back. So that's the end for this router. But I can open the switch. Let's open the switch. Yes, open this thing. Okay. I actually, before I become a lecturer, my dream is to be a surgeon. But this is as close I can get to become a surgeon. Okay, so let's unbox this thing. Only three screws here. To unbox, to really open a Cisco switch, only three screws. This is not good security. Anyway, like, come, let me show you. Hold on. Okay, I have the strength to do this. Yes, end up I become someone talking to the screen, talking to myself in front of a screen. So first screw is up. Let's take out the second screw here. So we have a second screw here. Don't worry, I'm a trained professional because I built all my IKEA furniture myself. Thanks to IKEA, I can unbox the switch easily now. I'm very good with screwdriver now. Hold on, just trying to get the last screw out. Okay, done. So all screw has already get them out. So now I will just open this thing. I hope I have the energy to open this. Yeah, this side out. Well, it's not as easy as it looks. Let me try harder. If you see this room suddenly just cut off, you know what happened. Yes, I managed. Let's look at this. Are you ready? You ready for it? Ta-da! Oh, this is the inside of a switch. Okay, let's zoom this in. So yeah, looks very similar to your motherboard on your PC, or if you're having a custom desktop right now, it looks very, very similar. And we'll now go through some of the internals here. Yeah, you are right. Actually, I just take the cockroach out. So here, this is the IC. If you can see, there is a Cisco system here. See that? So that is the processor of a switch. Now this processor is a custom design IPC, similar to what you have your Intel i7, i5 or Apple M1 chip. So this is a chip designed by Cisco, but it doesn't run Facebook or Instagram or anything. It is only capable to do routing, switching and stuff like that. Alright. Now of course this is a switch, so this one cannot do routing. It can only do switching. Okay. But yeah, what you should know is they have custom instruction sets that is not found on your custom 8x86 chip. That is a general purpose one. This is a special purpose chip just for networking, just to do something like, okay, when I have a packet come in, what do I do next? Should I send it out, or should I kill it, or should I keep it? So this guy here is going to process all that stuff. All right so this one is the heat sink, just to keep the switch cool when it is under load. So yeah, looks cool, but no RGB. Too bad. Why no RGB? Pay so much but no RGB. And the other thing you realize is, like, just now when I open, I realized something. I opened this thing, look at here, almost half empty. It's like the bag of potato chip you buy. 70% of them is air, only 30% is the real potato. Okay, now let's look at another thing here. What else do we have? Maybe I can show you this. Yeah, this one. If you look at this thing here, right here on top, it could be one of these. I'm not sure which one is which, but this is called a ROM. Okay, so just like your own real PC here, every time you start up your PC, you will notice that the time and the date is always synchronized. It won't be like, okay, I turn off my PC, then my clock on the PC will lag. So why, when we turn off the machines, your clock is still running? Because there's this thing called a CMOS battery or something. Okay, now, that thing here is also somewhere here. I cannot find that thing yet because it's really, really small. And then this is the ROM. Now, the ROM is where you put in the operating system flash. Okay, just like your window. When you first cold boot your window, it will load the operating system that you have already installed on the machines to the memory so that you can use your machines, right? Now, where is the OS store before you turn on this whole thing? It is stored here, either this one or this one. Okay, it's called the ROM, where we flash all the operating system logic into it. And then when you start, it will load the thing and then come to the processor. Okay, so this is one of the thing here is the ROM. So the other one is the memory, because just like your PC, this is actually a PC. Just this PC cannot run Dota, cannot run Cyberpunk, okay? It's just for routing, but it's just a PC, so you also have the RAM. And the RAM is about, I think, 64 megabytes only, all right? And then here, on the other side is, you have all the capacitor and chips. This is like the battery, I think. Yeah, looks like the M and N here. My favorite color. Blue MMM is my favorite color. Yeah, and then you have all the ICs and other stuff. This one looks like, this bridge is from Singapore. I think there's a bridge that looks like that in Singapore. Why they put a bridge inside a switch? Maybe it's just to protect this thing. Because this thing is actually where you put in all the 8 ports here, where you connect the device. Okay, I'm just trying to make some wild guess here because I don't have the documentation of this thing. So I'm just telling you based on what I really know and what I've seen. So yeah, this is the inside of a switch. And if you want to see the inside of a router, please wait one day if I make a lot on YouTube, maybe I can do an unboxing for a router. Now, I don't know how I'm going to put this back. So I'll just put this aside first. And I hope nobody noticed this. Okay, so that is the switch. Now, we'll take another 10-minute breaks right now. Okay, so when we come back, I will show you how we are going to go to TryHackMe and start to build our own network now. Okay, Arduino can connect to it. No, Arduino cannot connect to this. Arduino itself is already a switch, so you don't need to connect that to a real switch. Mini network controller, that's what I can think of. Okay, don't worry. I'm a trained unboxing guy, but I cannot put it back. So yeah, guys, let's go for a 10-minute break. But before that, I have something that I want to brief you. So please don't go first. I want you to go to this website right now. So for those who have not installed Packet Tracer, for the next part of this stream, we'll be building our first local area network together. So we will do this together because it's our first time. And I need you to have Packet Tracer installed. So for those who have not get Packet Tracer, this is how you do it. Go to the Datacom website here and scroll to Try Hack Me. Now the first challenge is already active. It's online right now. So you can just click here and then it will bring you to a Try Hack Me page. Now for those who have not made any account, this is the good time for you to make an account. Remember, use a name that nobody can trace back to you. Like maybe your in-game name, whatever, I think you're good with that. Make an account and then try to join this room. Now you go to task 3. Scroll all the way to task 3. Alright, so in task 3, you will see a link. Now this link here, you can click and download a zip file, and in the zip file there will be an installer called Packet Tracer. Now once you download, it will look something like this. Just want to download this again to show you how fast my internet is. Okay. Now it will look something like this. Now I need all of you here to go and install this thing, this Packet Tracer. If you have not already done so, please install this one. And when we come back, we'll be building our first network together using this Packet Tracer. Alright, so I'll see you back in 9:40. Take our time to do the setup, and then we'll start with our first challenge of the day.
One more time.
Oh, no, I think we did
it. I think we got this one.
Yeah, we're just getting in the groove.
Now let's leave them wanting more.
Yeah, you've grown 400 pounds since we started.
Meanwhile, I look exactly the same.
It means no worry.
Can you tell them to stop? Oh,
you insisted we sing this song.
I insisted you started singing it.
It's our signature song. We shouldn't be sharing it.
But it's our signature song, so we have to. Look, just tell them to stop.
It means no worry.
Oh, now he's riffing, Puma. This is a nightmare.
Gender. 小小情绪对我来说，
我也不知为何伤口还没愈合，你就这样闯进我的心窝。是你让我看见干枯沙漠开出花一朵，
是你让我想要每天为你写一首情歌，
用最浪漫的副歌
你也轻轻地附和，眼神坚定着我们的选择。
是你让我的世界从那刻变成粉红色，
是你让我的生活从此都只要你配合，
爱要精心买雕刻，
我是米开朗基罗，用心刻画最幸福的风格，
用时间去思念。情有点甜，这心愿不会变，爱情有点甜。
已经约定过一起过下个周末，你的小小情绪对我来说，
我也不知为何伤口还没愈合，你就这样闯进我的心窝。
操场等你，夏天真的什么都可以，带你去吃草莓冰淇淋。如果你有一点坏心情，我为你弹肖邦圆舞曲，听到这首轻松的旋律，好像吃了夹心巧克力。当我偷偷看你，当我偷偷想着你，像是深奥的问题，我们的爱情是丘比特安排的游戏，下老脸的傻傻分不清，你说靠在我的肩膀有心电感应，说不清要不像是梦境，我们的爱情是两颗星星眯着眼睛，还是命中注定我们会在一起，牛顿说过有种东西叫温柔引力，下一场大雨，我和你撑伞雨中穿。
穿行，收集每个点点滴滴，喜欢你瞪着的大眼睛，对什么事情都很好奇，每天拿着苹果想定义，该爱到了吃饭都忘记，当我偷偷看你的我偷偷的想着你，甚至深奥的问题，我们的爱情是丘比特安排的游戏，还是月下老人他傻傻分不清，你说靠在我的肩膀有心电感应，说不清又不像是梦境，我们的爱情是两个星星眯着眼睛，
Okay, guys, welcome back to our lecture 2. So now this is the last part of today's class, and it will just be a quick briefing on how are we going to do the challenge and what I'm expecting from you. Okay, so now I see that some of you are actually having some issues trying to download and install. So if you have anything that you need help, you can DM me on Microsoft Teams after the class and I'll fix that for you. Alright. Now for those who already have the Packet Tracer running, yeah, that's great. And we can now do this, we can now try to do this together. So, correct, Sarah. Wow, Sarah, this is so profound. Ignore all your problems and it will go away. I think I should code this and frame this in my wall. That is so profound, Sarah. Okay, now let's start this together. So if you have Packet Tracer already up, this is how you open the file. You will have a file called Bob the Builder, and this is the activity that I've designed so that later on you guys can learn how to build a network together. So before that, let me show you how I open any PKA file. So you click on the open button here on Packet Tracer, and then click Bob the Builder, open, and you should see a big network appear like this. Alright, now over here, this is the Packet Tracer drawing pane on the left, and you should have another window which is called Packet Tracer Activity. Now depending on how big is your screen is, you can just resize them according to whatever you feel is comfortable, alright? So let's say if you have external monitor, then it's a good idea for you to move this to another screen. If you only are using a laptop, which means that you have to open a window for YouTube because you need to watch my face, and then you need this and this, so it's going to be a bit small. So yeah, and that is actually a great reason for you to buy an external monitor now. Okay, if you haven't get an external monitor, go and get it. It makes you look more like a programmer. Okay, now let me explain a little bit about Packet Tracer. So Packet Tracer is a networking design tool by Cisco. It's really, really great. is used by a lot of pros out there. Although the interface look a bit like 98-ish, always old school style, but this is really great program. And one of the main purpose of Packet Tracer is for us to try out our network. Now think about this. If let's say today, you go and get, you are assigned to work in Huawei. Let's say Huawei. Then your boss say, okay, I need you to build 3 new networks. Based on what you learn in Datacom, go and build 3 networks which are really, really fast, but don't spend too much money because we are China. Because China HQ don't allow us to spend that much. Okay, something like this. So you always have constraint when you are working in a real life challenge, right? So now, how do I do that? Of course, if you are the kind of guy who, okay, I don't have any planning, then I just think maybe this might work. And I go and get a few switches and a few routers, and then I try to build the network. So, of course, 2 things can happen. First, you get lucky and it works. Yes, congratulations. If that happened, then please let me know what God do you pray to, because I need that as well. But most of the time, 9 out of 10, it will not happen. All right? So whatever you buy will be just end up being wasted because you don't have a proper planning. So so what happened? If you buy something, it doesn't work, then you have to return them in 14 days, Lazada return policy. Otherwise, you'll be out of job in the next after the 14 days because you waste company money. So Packet Tracer is here for us so that we can try to build a network here, and we try to test out the network first before we actually commit to buying the real hardware. So over here is really fun. We can you can see over here, there are so many devices that we can play with, which is actually real networking device that you can buy. And then you will try, later on you'll see if the network that we build really works, whether there are connectivity, whether it is fast, whether who is up, who is not up, things like that. So this is really, really fun if you are into this kind of networking stuff. So I'll just explain a little bit on the UI part. Now, on over here, the instructions is where you see like, okay, what I need to do now, what I need to do next, okay? And then over here, these are all the networking devices. Now, if you look at the bottom right corner, like what we learned earlier, you have routers, you have Bob, the builder file is come together with the zip file. Okay, so you see over here, you have, thank you for all the guys who are helping me in the Q&A sections. Shout out to you. You are my little assistant. So yeah, here, this is the router. If you need router, you click on this one here, and then it will show you all different routers. Now, the one that I show you physically just now is this one, 1841. Now, if you need a switch, you click here, then you will see all different range of switch. Now, of course, they are different in terms of some are faster, some you can build more network, some are more expensive, okay? Now, these are all the hubs. And this one here, this lighting one is the cable. So all the cable that we have learned so far, you can find them here. Alright, the best thing is it's actually free, so you don't have to pay anything. And all the end devices are here. You have your PC, your laptop, and things like that are here. So later on, I'll show you example number one. So I'll be building the first network with you. Okay, in this challenge, you need to build 3 networks. One in yellow one, one in blue, and one in green. I will finish the first challenge with you. And then you will go and do the both the rest of the network. Alright. So Packet Tracer, there are 2 challenges today. First one you see here, I need you to look at the right side on the activity window. Now if you look at the bottom corner, there is actually a completion. So this one is a guided challenge, means that every time you do something right, it will give you some marks. If you do something wrong, it won't take away the marks. Okay, so it's really cool so that you can know whether you're making the right progress, whether you're doing the right thing or not. Okay, now, another trick here is you see there is a check result buttons. If you click on the check results, why is this guy coming up? Okay, check results, it shows you all the itemized things. So if you click on the assessment item, now you'll see it shows you all the assessment, like, okay, what is done right, what is not done right, what is yet to be done. So it's very clear cut for us to see, okay, this is correct, so I don't want to mess with this. And then this is not done yet, so I have to spend time here. For some reason, nobody ever call me, but every time I have a class, my phone cannot stop ringing. Why? Okay, just let it ring out. So yeah, again, coming back to this, you can see for this particular challenge, we have 45 points. Now, if you get everything right, you'll get 45 out of 45. Okay, so this is just the challenge for Packet Tracer itself. Now, of course, there is another challenge on Try Hack Me. So if you go back to Try Hack Me here, in this room here, there are different set of challenges. So Try Hack Me challenge score is different from Packet Tracer. Now you need to complete the first Packet Tracer challenge first, because with that only you can answer some of the questions here. Now the score here is for the questions that you see here. Now Try Hack Me is a bit different. Let's say I take one example. I'll show you this later. If you get again like the question correctly, you'll be awarded some marks, and then you can see whether your name made it to the top 10 of the class out of 300 people. Yeah, so this is different, but for you to do this, you need to first make sure you finish the Packet Tracer challenge first. Alright, which is this one. So you need to get these full marks before you go back to Try Hack Me. So let me show you how I built the first network. Now, it might be a bit hard for you if the screen is too small. Just let me know if you need me to zoom in or anything. Alright? Okay, cool. Now, first, let's read the instructions. On computer networking, you always get all the hardware fixed before software. So you want to buy, make sure you buy all the correct hardware. Step 2, link them together using the right cables. Step 3, set IP address. So let's do step number 1. Buy 3 PC. So we need to buy 3 PC from N device. Generic, click on the first one. This will give you a PC. Now if you click on the pane here, left click here, it will give you PC 0. The other way you can also do is you just click and left click here, left click, and then you drag and drop here also can, depending on whichever you like, okay? If you want it to be in a specific position immediately, then you can just drag and drop. So yeah, PC1. Now, in this example, just a reminder, I need everyone to start with PC1 because we are programmer. In your programming class, you will learn array. And programmer knows array always start from 0, don't start from 1. So we don't want to use PC0. This one is just decoration we put it in our storeroom. Okay, so we buy 3 PC here, PC1, 2, 3. Now, next thing, the order doesn't matter. It doesn't mean that you have to draw this in particular way and then you get more marks or it looks cooler. Maybe it looks cooler if you look from the Google Map top-down view, the eagle view. But on Packet Tracer, it doesn't matter how you place them. As long as you connect them correctly, that's more than enough. So we have 3 PC here. And then the next thing is you need to buy a switch. Okay, so instructions to buy a switch. So I go to this switch here, bottom left corner, second one on the top row. I buy the first one, 295024, because I want to follow the model exactly. So I click here. Now I have a switch already. And then the last one is I need to buy a router. The model is 1841. So here, click here, router. The first one is the one that we are looking for. 1841. That's it. So here I already buy all the hardware that I need. Step 1 is done. Step 2, we want to connect them together. Alright? So connecting device is not that easy because in computer network, there are so many different type of cables. So which cable should I be using? Alright, now in this case, I don't need you to remember what cable to use. Okay, so this is the trick. If you look at the Packet Tracer here, that is the first kind of cable is a lightning cable. This is not the lightning cable from Apple that charges your iPhone or iPad. No, this is auto mode. So if you use this lightning, it means that Packet Tracer will automatically tell you what kind of cable is the right one. So for example, if I want to connect PC1 to a switch, I can just left click here and then I go to the switch, I left click again, then you get a cable like this. So this is called the auto mode. I don't need to know what are the cable type, I will just connect them. Alright, now in this subject, I don't recommend you to use auto mode to build the whole network. We only use auto mode to find out what is the right cable type. So you see the trick is here, I don't know what is the cable. I have so many different cables. I have a copper straight through, should I be using this? Or should I be using this crossover cable? So I do not know which one. Alright? So the easy way is I use the auto mode. So I will just delete all these things first. Okay, sorry. Don't worry about the color. Okay. So if you want to delete, again, this is where you can delete. Just click X and then point it on the things that you want to remove. Then I use auto mode and go here. Okay, from here, I know this is actually a straight cable. See, this design and this design is the same. So this is how I know which cable I want to use. All right, now why we don't use auto mode directly? This is because, let's say you use auto mode, the port number will automatically be assigned. Now, if you look at the back of a switch, this is the back of the switch. There are so many ports. Sometimes I want to be very particular. I want this port. I want to be very sure I connect to this port. Now, if you use auto mode, it always start with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You cannot choose. So if the exam say in the questions, connect to port number 8, if you use auto mode, you won't get the marks because it will go to port number 1. So again, as a reminder, we only use auto mode to find out what is the cable type, and then from there, we will manually connect the cable ourselves because we are all cable men, right? So here, I click on this cable here, click on PC1, click on Fast Ethernet, alright, left click, and then you go here, choose Fast Ethernet 01, okay, click here, then the first one is done. Now, the way I choose is because the instruction says connect PC1 to FA01, PC2 to FA02, PC3 to FA03. Now, of course, in this case, if you use the auto mode, it happens that you are lucky, you will still get the same thing, just because you are lucky. So, again, always do this on your own. Now, wait, this is not right. So, let me move this here, PC2 and PC3. So, PC2, I go to the switch, I connect to the second port, FA02. Okay, now, same thing, PC3, I go to the port here, FA03. This is according to the instructions. I'm just doing exactly what my boss told me to do. Alright? Then if you are done with this, the last one, connect FA04 on switch to the router. So now it's between the switch and the router. So what is the type of cable? Again, I do not know. So I have to use auto mode to find out first. Okay, this is the cable type. Okay, just to be safe, I will delete this. And then I connect this manually. So I found out that this is the cable type, right? So I click here, click on the switch, FA04, according to the instructions, FA04, click on the router, FA00, the first one. Okay, this is exactly the same router that I showed you earlier. If you click inside, you see, it's exactly the same thing. Look at this thing. This is the back of the router that I just showed you. So again, you can build two networks like we discussed earlier. So the first one is here, the second one is here, which is why just now when I connect, I need to choose, should I connect to the first one or second one? Now, according to the instructions, I will connect to FA00, and that's it. That's done. Now, the last part here, I will just take you 5 more minutes. Okay, guys, 5 more minutes. If you have a class, you can go now, and then you can always come back to replay the video. So after you buy the correct device, after you connect them using the correct cable to the correct port number, now you want to put IP address. Okay, so step 3, assign IP address. So let's read the instruction first. PC1 later, I will put 192.168.1.1. PC2 is 1.2. This is PC3 is 1.3. So this is static IP. Static IP means I want to put IP manually. So I click on PC1, left click on PC1, you go to desktop tab. So on the top, there is 1, 2, 3, 4. Go to the third one, desktop tab. And then go to this thing called IP configurations. All right. So this is where you type in IP. Click here. And this is where you can type. So example number one, PC1 is 192.168.1.1. Okay. This is from the instructions here, 1.1. Okay. Now, after that, you will see this mask automatically appear. So you don't have to type anything here. Just leave it as 255.255.255.0. And then the default gateway. Now, if you remember, default gateway is your router IP. So here, this is given already. It's 1.254. So I will just type 192.168.1.254. That's it. if you have put this in correctly, it means that you already give the IP properly to PC1. So you can just click here to close it. Like what Sarah say, just close everything if you don't want to face them. So close it. Yeah, that's it. If you look at the marks here, look at the marks at the bottom right corner, 15% already. So we know we are making the steady progress here, okay? Now I repeat the same for PC2. I go to desktop, go to IP, go to here, type in 1.2, and then this is the router IP, which is again coming from the instructions. So 1.2.255.255.255.0.1.254. Now if this is correct, then close this, we do for PC3, the last one. So again from the instructions, we need to put 1.3, and then router IP is the same for all three PC because they are actually in the same network. Alright, so 254, done. You should get 26 mark now. Now if you check activity, you can actually see that PC 1, 2, 3, you get all the green tick. Green tick is a good sign in Packet Tracer. It's not so good in WhatsApp or Messenger, but it's a good sign in Packet Tracer. It means you got all this correctly already. Alright, so you're supposed to have 13 by now. So you can go back here and then do the last activity of today. So today I'll show you the last part here. Instructions number 9. We want to assign IP to router. So router also need IP address. A switch don't need to have IP. So now you see it's still red color. Once we give IP to router, it will become green color. Okay, so I click router 0. Okay, hold on. Okay, and then you go to config tab, the second one on top. Now you have to be careful here. There are two interfaces, like what I showed you earlier. You can build two networks here. Now remember we connect to 00 earlier, so you want to make sure you are in FA00 here. Make sure you don't put in the wrong interface. And here this is where you put in the IP address of your router, 1.254. Okay, 1.254, and then here just do a left click, it will automatically appear. Alright, now if you've done this, this is actually correct. Means everyone have IP now. Everyone should be able to talk to each other because now we are all in the same local area network. Now the problem is, if you look here, it's still red color. This is because we have not turned on the interface. So this is something that you should always remember. Every time you put in an IP on a router, it means you have to do the setting, but you have not activated it. So you need to do one extra step, which is to click here, turn it on. Okay, this is like the most common mistake everybody make, you know. There are like 50% of the students who always do this mistake. In the lab test, they always set all this correctly, but then they don't get the marks because they forget to turn it on. Okay, I hope this doesn't happen to you lah. Then if you turn it on, you check again, now it will become orange color, and after a while, it will become green color. See, now it's green color. Now if you have something like this, it means everything has been set up properly. This right now here is your first local area network. Alright, now how do I know whether you have done this thing correctly? Of course, the first way is you check result. If you have 15 out of 45, that means you are on the right track. You just need to finish the rest. Of course, there is a better way. Now I'll show you the better way. I want to know whether the network is working. So what I can do is I can go to PC1. I try to ping to another PC in the network. So ping is a command, a network command that we use to check connectivity. Just like whether you want to know someone is reachable or not, you use the ping command. Alright, so this example here. Ping PC1 to PC2. So if this guy here can talk to this guy here, it means the network is working. Alright, so I go into PC1 now. I go to this command prompt here. Okay, and now I will use the ping command. Ping followed by the IP address. Now this IP address has to be the destination IP, not your own IP. So in my example, PC1 is trying to see whether I can talk to PC2. So PC2 is the destination. PC1 is the sender, the source, right? So if I want to ping from PC1 to PC2, I need to put PC2 IP address from PC1. Okay, so I need to go to PC2 to find out what is PC2 IP again. If you like, you are like me, you cannot remember, then yes, this is how I do it, okay? But if you can remember, then that's cool. So PC2 IP is 1.2. So in PC1, I will ping to 192.168.1.2. All right, so this is the command here. Ping space followed by where you want to check the connectivity. If you press enter, you will get a reply. If you get a reply, means yeah, good news, we can end the class today here. Okay, now of course, if you ping to an IP which is not reachable, like 1.4, we know that right now no one is having 1.4. So if you have ping here, you get in the shower, you see a request timeout. Means that this is a failure. You cannot get to this guy, but you can get to this guy. All right, so now that is the ping command. So if you can understand until this stage, we'll stop here. And for the rest of you who have done this one, you can continue with this activity. Try to get all 100 out of 100. And once you've done so, the last thing you need to do is just go back to this try hack me and try to answer some of the questions. Now, for example, I can do something like this. What is the gateway IP for LAN 1? So from packet tracer, I know gateway is router. So this is my router. This is the interface that I'm using on my router, FA00. So I just need to know what is the IP address for FA00, which is 192.168.1.254. If you are like me, lazy, you can even copy and paste, okay? Then you just go here, come back here, and then you type in 192.168.1.254, submit. If it is correct, you'll get it correct. And then you'll get the marks, okay? So by the end of this challenge, if you get all correct, at like, I don't know how many, 50 or 50, then you'll see your names appear here, okay? In the next class, I will do a shout out to everyone who complete all the challenge. You'll get into the Hall of Fame, okay? So yeah, I think that's all for this class. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you same time next week for the next lecture. Okay, so I'll see you again. Bye-bye.